Friends, welcome back to my channel. In my last video, when I was discussing about the usage of series lamp and workbench safeties, I demonstrated that we can check the input impedance for any circuit, either it is short circuit or not, and I demonstrated that we can check the input resistance. It is showing 8.7 mega ohm. Okay, but this circuit have short circuit. It have short circuit in DC rail at this point. If we test the input resistance, that is high, but if we check at the capacitor terminal, that is here. So it is short. If we test the IC, the ground line is reaching here at the source. So it is drain to source, it is short circuit. And if we check the resistance at capacitor end, so it is just only 7 ohms. When I am testing the resistance here, it is showing in mega ohm. But when we connect it practically in the power, it is illuminating full. Why? Because our this IC have internally short circuit. But what is the reason? When we tested with multimeter, it is giving open circuit 8 mega ohms. Why? This is a question from my viewer. The sender name is also thank you. I will also say thank you for writing a beautiful and very pure technical comment. Can you explain why resistance between two power terminals showed in mega ohms even it is shorted? Yes, let's discuss. When I am connecting the multimeter here, it is giving 7 mega ohms. In the reverse direction, it is giving 8.6 mega ohms. And if I want to test this diode, okay, let me install the short leads. In the resistance mode, when we want to test diode, these digital multimeters check the resistance. The cable is good. If I will test this diode, it is 4007, red lead to the cathode, black lead to the anode, it is OL, reverse the leads, it is 2.7 mega ohms. Why? But if I will check the same diode in diode mode, it is giving 0.6 volt. What is the reason? If I will shift to resistance mode, it is giving 2.9 mega ohms. That's wonderful. Okay, I will use another multimeter. This is continuity mode. In continuity mode, it is not showing anything. Move to resistance mode. It is 59 kilo ohms. And if I will reverse it, open. Now I am in diode mode. It is giving 0.589. This multimeter is giving 0.59. In resistance mode, it is 59 kilo ohms. Yes. But here, this multimeter, it is giving 2.89 mega ohms. Why? In diode mode, it is 0.59, the same here. The answer that when we use these multimeters, digital multimeters, these use very light test signal, very low value test signal. Set this multimeter to DC voltage mode and it is using 524 millivolt signal. To test the resistance, it is just only in millivolts, 5 to 4 millivolts. When we want to test this diode with this weak signal, it cannot cross the junction, because to test this diode we need 0.6 volt and our testing signal, that is just only 500 millivolt, so it cannot cross the junction. But okay, if I will use the diode mod, this time the test signal value is 3.2 volt. So that is the reason when we connect here with this test signal, it will show the dropped voltage here. That is 0.6 volt here, 0.6 volt here. When we are testing it in the resistance mode, we can see it is showing 2.8 mega ohm and just only 221 millivolt signal is dropped. Why? Because it is generating just only 500 millivolt, and out of 500 millivolt, 220 millivolt are being dropped here, so it is showing this resistance. So this is the reason we cannot test diode in ohm mode. When we cannot test one diode in this with this multimeter in resistance mode, let me show now the test circuit. So this is our equivalent circuit that I was showing here, which is short circuit. I will connect the short circuit here again. This time, if I will use this multimeter to test the input resistance, it cannot detect. Why? Because its test signal is very low. So 500 millivolt signal, it will not detect the short circuit. It is just only dropping 300 some millivolt here. So that is the reason this multimeter cannot detect the short circuit at input terminal. Even if I will connect here, it is showing 8.6 mega ohms. If I will switch to diode mode, now it is showing 1.2 volt. Why? Because our one diode will drop 0.6 volt. Now this is the answer of our question. If we have short circuit here, if I will connect in diode mode here, if the circuit is good in any direction, it will give OL, open circuit. And if I will use, this is a good circuit, if I will use diode mode here, it is open circuit. But if we check this circuit, it is giving 1.2 volt. The same, this multimeter is giving 1.2 volt. It is the reason it is using 3.2 volt signal to test the diode. For testing resistance, it is just only taking 0.5 volt, 500 millivolt signal. Okay, let's see. When we select the range, at that time, it will use diode mode, 3.2 volt test signal. It is coming out from this multimeter. Okay. Now we will see the resistance. For resistance, it is giving 524 millivolt. Now I will change range manually. In mega ohm, high resistance, it will use this test signal. If we will use ohms range, the low range, it will use 1 volt signal. Kilo ohms, the same 1 volt. But when it want to test high resistance, at that time it will use low value signal. Now I will make a jumper to make short circuit, and then we will see how we can find in resistance mode. When the output circuit is good, in resistance mode it is giving in mega ohms, and if I will make a short circuit here, now it is 5.5 mega ohms. The similar here, but if I will use the diode signal, it is 1.1 volt. 1.1 volt, why? Because this time the test signal for the diode, 3 volt signal in any direction. If you connect positive lead here, negative lead here, or negative here, positive here, if I am connecting positive voltage here, this diode forward bias, and from this jumper, 0.6 here, 0.6 here, 1.1 volt, 1.2 volt are dropped here. If I will connect leads in reverse direction, the same this line. To detect short circuit, we can also use this analog multimeter. It is very nice tool to detect short circuit. First of all, let's see its test signal. In DC voltage mode, I will connect its test leads here. Here it is using 3.2 volt signal in low resistance mode. X10, X1, 3.2 volt. X10, 3.2 volt. X100, 3.2. X1K, 3.2. And at this range, it will use 12 volt signal, because it have two batteries, 1.5 volt, two batteries, and 9 volt. When we select higher range, multiplier, 10K multiplier, at that time it will use 12 volt signal to test resistance, because it is using more voltage, so it can cross the barrier of the diodes. Let's connect test probes here. Now it is 10K and it is around 1, so scale multiplier 10K, so it is 10K, 10 kilo ohm resistance. So 10 kilo ohm resistance is low resistance. Okay, select to 1K. Now it is using 3 volt signal. It is around 5, 6, 7, about 7 kilo ohms. Here at 100, let's see, it's 0, because in these multimeters we always, for each testing, we need 0 adjustment. Now it is 0. Yes, it is around 8. And if we check the HFE signal, that is gain signal, that is for transistor testing, at this scale it uses 15 milliampere current. And if we see the equivalent circuit, that is here, if I will connect here, it is giving short circuit, that there is a short link. And if I will remove this short circuit here, it will give open circuit. And if we test the resistance of one diode, if we check the resistance of forward resistance of this diode, it is showing about, it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 multiplied by 10, 40. And if I will connect here, it is open. And if I will make short circuit, as this IC is short circuit here, so it is giving 100, it is giving 10 multiplied by 10, 100 ohms. So that means it is detecting the short circuit. While if we connect digital multimeter, in resistance mode, it will show in mega ohms, 7.7 mega ohms. But if we will check in diode mode, at that time it will display the diode drop voltage. So this is the reason that the test signal here in the digital multimeters, it is weak signal. As we tested in our this circuit, if this circuit is good, there is no short circuit, at that time it is open. And if we have any short circuit in the second stage, in the power inverter stage, at that time it will give us this reading, 100 ohm resistance. So 100 ohm resistance, that is very low resistance. The similar here, is giving 100 ohm resistance, that means we have problem in the circuit. So to detect the short circuit here, we can use the diode function, that is best. In the diode mode, we can see the diode drop voltage if the circuit is bad. If the circuit is good, at that time it will give open circuit. Anytime we have short circuit here in the power stage, inverter stage, that is transformer winding and this IC, it will give 1.2 volt drop. When we are testing here, if the second stage is bad, it will show 1.2 volt. If any one diode is bad, we will find one diode drop voltage. If we have the second stage, the transformer and the IC is bad, MOSFET is bad, at that time we will find two diode drop voltage if the diode and the capacitor is good. I hope so you enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed, hit the like button. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.